Hello everyone. In the previous lecture, I have given you the introduction about the orthographic projection, about the two principal planes and how the projections are drawn onto the plane by using the projectors that are the straight lines drawn from the object of the given object. Okay, so here we will move towards our main topic, that is the second module about projection of points and lines. Before moving to the projection of lines, we will study the projection of points, and in that we will study the basic about the projection of points. Okay, now I think you are familiar with the x-axis and y-axis while drawing the geometry. We are familiar with the x-axis and y-axis and the quadrants formed by the intersection of this x and y-axis. So, this x and y-axis are at a 90 degree with each other. Okay. So, due to this, there are four main quadrants. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. In first quadrant, the x-coordinate and y-coordinate both are positive. In second, the x coordinate is negative and y coordinate is positive. In third, both the coordinates x and y are negative. And in fourth, x coordinate is positive and y coordinate is negative. So this representation of x-axis and y-axis is in the 2D form. Okay, if we have to express it in the 3D form, it looks like this. Okay, these are two planes. This is the vertical plane and this is the horizontal plane. When vertical plane and horizontal plane are at right angle to each other, they also divide the parts into four quadrants: first, second, third, fourth. The Hensel's representation 3D they are shown. In projection of points, what we have to study? We have seen the projection of an object on a projecting plane. एक अपन मी तुम्हाला आधीच्या लेक्चर मध्ये एक्सप्लेन केलंय की ऑब्जेक्ट जर असेल तर त्याचे प्रोजेक्शन्स कसे काढतो. इफ वी आर एन ऑब्झर्वर, इफ वी आर ऑब्झर्विंग दॅट ऑब्जेक्ट, देन थ्रू द एव्हरी पॉइंट्स ऑर एजेस ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट्स द स्ट्रेट लाईन्स आर ड्रॉन ऑन टू द projecting plane. That straight lines are called as projectors, and this projectors are parallel to each other and are at right angle to the projecting plane. Let me explain here. So ata we have question kind of example. We have projection of planes with respect to the quadrants. फर्स्ट क्वाड्रंटमध्ये पॉईंट असेल तर त्याचं प्रोजेक्शन आपण कसं काढणार. सेकंड क्वाड्रंटमध्ये असेल तर हा वी विल ड्रॉ द प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ द सेम. थर्ड क्वाड्रंट, फोर्थ क्वाड्रंट, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द पोझिशन ऑफ द पॉइंट्स इन द रिस्पेक्टिव क्वाड्रंट वी हॅव टू ड्रॉ द प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ द पॉइंट्स. बट डायरेक्टली एक्झाममध्ये दिलं जात नाही की ड्रॉ द प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ द पॉइंट इफ अ पॉइंट इज इन द फर्स्ट क्वाड्रंट. नो, इट इज नॉट गिवन डायरेक्टली. सो for explaining the position of the point in the respective quadrant, basic four words are used: on, below, in front and behind. Now we will study this. Manje kay, ata mi tumcha already 3D tayar kele planes. Okay, he tayar kelela. This is the vertical plane. See, this is the vertical plane VP. Vertical plane la denote kya karto apan VP, and this is the horizontal plane which is denoted as HP. Now this both the planes are at an right angle with each other. This both the planes are at an right angle with each other. Now see, so this is the first quadrant, this is the second quadrant, this is the third quadrant and this is the fourth quadrant. Now we will study the position of the points in the respective quadrant or plane. Now for example, if this is a point, consider this as a point. If point is here, how will you explain the position of the point? That the point is on HP. हे कसं एक्सप्लेन करणार तुम्ही? हा एच पी आहे, बरोबर, एच पी वर ठेवलाय. सो काय एक्सप्लेन करणार? द पॉइंट इज ऑन एच पी, ऑर यू कॅन ऑल्सो से पॉइंट इज इन एच पी. ओके, सो हे एच पीचं झालं व्हेन इट इज ऑन एच पी. जर हा इथे असेल, सी हा, दिस इज अ बॅक बॅक ऑफ द एच पी. जर पॉइंट इथं असेल तर हॅव विल यू एक्सप्लेन द पोझिशन ऑफ द पॉइंट? Here you can explain as the point is below the HP, right? This is below the HP, this is front of the HP and this is back of the HP. So this point is below the HP. This is with respect to HP. आता आपण with respect to HP बघितलं की इथं पॉइंट असेल तर इट इज ऑन द एच पी, अँड इथे पॉइंट असेल तर इट इज बिलो द एच पी. Now we will see with respect to VP. Now if the point is here, it is on the VP, right? And if the point is here, it is behind, right? So it is behind the VP. Clear? Now if we consider a point, see, if you consider a point in first quadrant at a distance x, say, from the HP, जर इथं पॉइंट असेल तर हा विल बी एक्सप्लेन पोझिशन. पॉइंट इज ॲट अ डिस्टन्स एक्स अबाउ द एच पी, अँड आता हे पीपीच्या समोर आहे, सो इट इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ पी पी. ओके, सिमिलरली इफ पॉइंट इज हिअर, सी, इफ पॉइंट इज इन सेकंड क्वाड्रंट हिअर, how will you explain the position? The point is at a distance x above the HP and this is the behind the VP. So how will you explain this position of the point? The point is above the HP and behind the VP. Now if we consider a point here, see, this is the third quadrant. If we consider a point here, then how will you explain the position? The point is below the HP and behind the VP. It is below the HP and behind the VP. Okay. Now, if the point is in fourth quadrant, the point it is here. See, this is the fourth quadrant, right? If point is here, how will you explain? The point is below the HP and in front of VP. If a point is said that it is below the HP and in front of VP. So, how do you distinguish the position of the point with respect to the first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant? So, आता आपण बघतो. We will see it again. This is first quadrant, right? See. This is first quadrant. Say that the point is in first quadrant. Now for second quadrant, what can we write? See, at the point iti hai second quadrant, so it is above the HP and behind the VP. Sorry, this is HP, right? It is above the HP and behind the VP. So in second quadrant, we can say that the point is in second quadrant if a point is above the HP and behind the VP. Okay. Now we will study about the third. Third मध्ये इथे असेल तर काय how will you explain? The point is below the HP and behind the VP. So a point is below the HP and behind the VP in third quadrant, and in fourth quadrant the point is below the HP. Okay, the point is below the HP and in front of VP here. So in fourth quadrant, point is below the HP and in front of VP. Why we need to study these positions? Now the first, second, third, fourth quadrant, with us, we will easily understand that point is on first, second, third quadrant. But in exam, they never tell you that the point is in first quadrant, point is in second quadrant, yeah, point is in fourth quadrant. They give the problem like, if a point is on point A is at a distance 4 cm above the HP and 3 cm in front of VP. Now from this, what, how will you tell that this point is in which quadrant? From this words, right? Above the HP and in front of VP. So first quadrant. So the point is in first quadrant. Easily understand honeyati madun. These four words are very important: on, below, in front, and behind. Okay. So for first quadrant, we can explain the position of point as point is above the HP and in front of VP. For second quadrant, we can explain as point is above the HP and behind the VP. In third quadrant, we can explain the point, location of the point as point is below the HP and behind the VP. Okay. The point is, in fourth quadrant, the point is below the HP and in front of VP. Okay. So here, what is VP and HP? VP is the vertical plane and HP is the horizontal plane. Okay. Now in next lecture, we will see how to actually draw the projection of the points. And we will solve some of the problems and draw the projections. For that, I will give you an idea of what it is called. See, this is in the 3D form. So if point is here, we cannot draw the projection of points in this manner, or don't consider about the points. We have to consider that we have to draw the projections of the object, which is very difficult. Okay, so if object is there, it is very difficult to draw it in 3D form. So apan kya karte ho, this is the vertical plane and this is the horizontal plane. Okay, we make the horizontal plane vertical like this way. Okay, so this will be our axis, xx, or say xy. So what we have done, we have just unfolded. So whatever the projections will be there in VP will be drawn above this line, and whatever projections will be in the HP we will draw below this line. Now we will get an idea of what will be visible in VP and HP. This is just an introductory part. We will study in deep in next lecture. Okay. For example, this is a rubber, right? It is in rectangular form. Okay. This is a rubber and it is in rectangular form. And you are looking from here. Okay. Jab tumhi itun bakhta hai as an observer, what you will look in the VP? Front view, this is na. This is nothing but front view. So, in VP, front view of the object will be seen. How? At the head, points at object. Tajatna apan projectors kaadna, straight lines kaadna, over to this plane. आणि त्या पॉइंट्सवरनं आपण स्ट्रेट लाईन ड्रॉ करून त्याचं प्रोजेक्शन काढणार. बट इन व्ही पी वी विल गेट दी फ्रंट व्ह्यू. आता जर आपण वरून बघितलं, वरून बघितलं तर एच पी मध्ये काय येणार, टॉप व्ह्यू येणार. सो जर आपण असं ड्रॉ करायला गेलो, स्ट्रेट लाईनच्या वरती व्ही पी आहे. सो व्ही पी मध्ये आपण काय बघितलं, दॅट फ्रंट व्ह्यू ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट इज सी. ओके, एच पी मध्ये काय बघितलं, टॉप व्ह्यू काढू शकतो. सो फॉर एक्झाम्पल दिस इज द फर्स्ट क्वाड्रंट, पॉइंट इज 3 सेंटीमीटर अबाव द एच पी अँड 4 सेंटीमीटर इन फ्रंट ऑफ व्ही पी. मग आता ह्या पॉईंटचे प्रोजेक्शन्स काढायला इझी नाही आहे इन 3D फॉर्म. सो वी जस्ट असं होतं ते आपण असं केलं. सो दिस इज द एक्सिस, ही एक्स वाय लाईन. सो ती एक्स वाय लाईन काढली. सो इफ यू आर ऑब्झर्वर, इफ यू आर द ऑब्झर्वर, जर आपण बघतो आहे तर इथे जो फ्रंट व्ह्यू आहे तो इथे येणार, इथे व्ही पीमध्ये. व्ही पीमध्ये वी विल ऑलवेज हॅव द फ्रंट व्ह्यू. And in HP, if you are looking from the top, you will see the top view of the object. So, in VP, VP will get the front view of the object. And in HP, we will get the top view of the object. Clear? Okay. In next lecture, I will tell you about how to draw the projection of points if points are located in different quadrants. Okay, for now the lecture is over.